Hi, Thamesview. Happy Canada Day. So I don't think I've overdone it at all, but I think we're pretty lucky that we live in this country, and we're going to start this whole service today by singing O Canada. And I've gone out on a limb here. We're going to sing the first verse in English like we normally do, and then we're going to sing the second verse in French. So I'd like you to try it. And hopefully you'll give it a go and do your best. And then we're going to sing a verse that we never sing. There's actually four verses, but we're going to sing the second verse. So I've added an extra verse there. So stand up if you're able and let's sing it. Ready? I said stand up.
Here we are, the last week of June. Hard to believe, isn't it? And almost Canada Day. We'll likely be celebrating it a little differently this year. Please, please don't give in to the idea of, oh, now we can have a big party. Please adhere to the safety rules and guidelines. I really like the Facebook post that I read this week that said, we're all getting tired of this isolation. The virus, however, is not tired. Please be careful, continue to be safe, and safe practices. Thanks to everybody for continuing to participate in the auction. There are lots of good items still to come. And thank you for remembering to continue your worship through your giving, either by checks and post-dated checks or by e-transfer. As we head into summer, of course, your offering will be needed all the more. I really appreciate your faithfulness, so thank you so much. We haven't made any final decisions about how services will take place over the next couple of months, but I'll let you know as soon as I know. There will be several announcements coming your way in the next week or so, exciting events and opportunities, so be sure to watch for those. And now, here's our scripture reading for today.
Hello everyone. Our readings for today are both from Psalms. Psalms 4-12 reads, "The word of the Lord is upright, and all his work is done in faithfulness. He loves righteousness and justice. The earth is full of the steadfast love of the Lord. By the word of the Lord, the heavens were made, and all their hosts by the breath of his mouth. For he spoke, and it came to be. He commanded, and it stood firm. The counsel of the Lord stands forever, the thoughts of his heart to all generations. Happy is the nation whose God is the Lord." Psalm 72, verses 1-8 reads, "Give the people's leader your justice, O God. May he judge your people with righteousness and your poor with justice. May he defend the cause of the poor and give deliverance to the needy. May he be like rain that falls on the mown grass, like showers that water the earth. In his days may righteousness flourish and peace abound until the moon is no more. And may you have dominion from sea to sea and to the ends of the earth." Happy Canada Day, everyone!
In April 1775, British essayist Samuel Johnson wrote, "Patriotism is the last refuge of the scoundrel." He was wrong. There is a profound difference between nationalism, which is bad, and patriotism, which is good. Nationalism is where one nation believes itself to be superior to all other nations. Einstein put it very well when he described nationalism as an infantile disease or the measles of mankind. Patriotism, however, is not nationalism, because it doesn't denigrate other nations or claim to have any inherent superiority over them. It is simply a heartfelt love of country. Like this. On days like Canada Day, patriotism has its place. There are times when we reserved Canadians need to celebrate our national heritage, as we will in just a few days, and say that for all the problems and difficulties in this nation, Canada remains one of the finest places on earth in which to live. There's nothing wrong with rekindling the pride of being Canadian and thanking God that we live in the true North, strong and free. Truthfully, I wouldn't want to live anywhere else. Those who founded Canada built a nation based on the rule of law and sound government, of tolerance and a strong work ethic. They formed a constitutional monarchy in which the dignity of the individual and the common good were both valued, in which those of different languages and religions come together rather than oppose one another, in which unity and diversity, compromise and confederation can join hands in a middle ground of civil discourse and mutual respect and consensus. At least that's the model. As the 153rd anniversary of Confederation approaches, Canada, although young, is Well, paradoxically, an old country, as confederations go. In fact, only the American and Swiss federations are older. And history is littered with failed federations and multinational empires. Even Britain is threatened to break up as Scotland continues to contemplate independence and Brexit isolates them even further. How ironic it would be if ancient Britain fell apart as a united country while Canada remains whole. This nation holds together, and in doing so, it sets an example to the world on how people of different races and religions, cultures, and ethnicities can join together as one people, live in mutual respect and practice tolerance in one glorious Canadian mosaic. I sometimes think that when the first President Bush spoke about a kinder, gentler America, he had a Canadian model in mind. We have what much of the world can only dream of. We are blessed in civility, compassion, and social cohesion when we choose to practice those things. But we're also blessed with, well, natural resources. Practically every commodity we need, we can find in this country. Fertile lands for crops and livestock, water galore. Even with the Dust Bowl of the 1940s, we've never known famine as a country. We go down to the mines and find every mineral that we ever need. From the shores of Newfoundland to the oil sands of Alberta, we have ample access to oil and gas. And if it weren't enough, God has also given us a feast for the eyes in this country. I know it sounds like a commercial, but you know, the magnificence of the Rockies? That's etched in my mind. The Gulf Islands off the coast of Vancouver are about as pristine as you'll find anywhere. The Cabot Trail in Cape Breton, amazing. Countryside of Quebec is truly la belle Provence. Here in Ontario, we enjoy the majesty of the Great Lakes, the rolling hills, farmland, and just a few hours away, rugged Bruce Peninsula and the Canadian Shield with spectacular lakes, rock formations. It's an amazing, beautiful place. It's also a welcoming land of opportunity. Just think of all the immigrants who have come to this country and prospered. They have embraced commerce, participated in politics, edified our minds, stirred our souls, and touched our hearts with imagination and invention, initiative, industry. This is a land of opportunity. Since 1982, we have been protected in the Canadian Charter of Rights and Freedoms, which ensures that even in dire circumstances, civil liberties and the rule of law prevails. It doesn't always happen. I know that. So do you. It's not exactly always the perfect country. But you know, I don't despair. Even Canadians don't act well when they don't act like Canadians, because there's still an accountability through the courts and the justice system. Rights and freedoms are still cherished, and the rule of law still matters, even if the system fails at times and needs to be re-examined and adjusted, and we have the freedom to do that as well. Canada being perfect? Well, we know better. An article in Canadian Business Magazine suggested that Canadians per capita are richer than Americans, and our nation is the envy of Europe. But even so, we still have grinding poverty in this country, in our cities, especially in our Indigenous communities. We find poor diet, substandard housing, chronic unemployment, alcoholism, drug addiction, violence against women, teen pregnancies, host of all other ills that plague many people in our country. Even in the smallest of communities, the food banks and charities are indispensable to the survival of so many people. We have grudges and rivalries between provinces. And we complain. We're complaining now because we've had to be isolated for a few months. Just a few months. We are always complaining about paying taxes. Even though the Bible says in Romans 13, you are to pay taxes, pay what is due. Taxes to those whom taxes are due, revenue to whom revenue is due, respect to whom respect is due, and honor to whom honor is due. This is not a suggestion. It's a command. You know, our political parties, they disagree and argue. Often, I think, just for the sake of arguing. But we still have them. We have the right to vote for them. Question them. By the way, have you taken the time to pray for the Prime Minister lately? Whether you agree with his politics or not, the Bible also says in 1 Timothy 2, first of all, then, I tell you that prayers, intercessions, and thanksgivings should be made for your rulers and for those in high positions, so that we might lead a gentle and peaceful life. Again, this is not a suggestion. Pray for our leaders. Yes, Canada falls short in many ways. We pollute and we exploit and we live on the greedy side. This nation, us, we are not perfect. But this is still a wonderful country. The Bible is clear that what makes a nation great is its compassion for the least, the last, and the lost among its citizens. It is our willingness to extend mercy to the vulnerable and the marginalized that show the true character of a nation and an individual and a Christian. On the night before he died, Jesus told us how to live, as he told his disciples, saying, "This is my commandment. Love one another as I have loved you." How? Giving everything. Self-sacrificial love. Unconditional acceptance. To love others as Jesus loved us. That is the Christian ethic, pure and simple. And I believe that a nation can only be as effective and thrive and serve as it is an example that practices that commandment of putting love into action. And we can only be examples as Christians and patriotic Canadians when we put God's love into action. On Canada Day, just a few days away, I believe it will be fitting for all of us to make a personal commitment to live lives pleasing to the Lord, and then to demonstrate that commitment in the unselfish management of our resources, the prayerful support of our leaders, the care for all those around us, and a loving affirmation of the principles that have guided this country over the years. On July 1st, 1960, in a speech on the Canadian Bill of Rights, Prime Minister John Diefenbaker spoke words that have resonated with Canadians to this day. He said, "I am a Canadian, free to speak without fear, free to worship in my own way, free to stand for what I think is right, free to oppose what I believe to be wrong, or free to choose those who govern my country. This heritage of freedom I pledge before God to uphold for myself and for all people." May that be our pledge before God as well. Happy birthday, Canada.
We're going to do a hymn called "O God of All the Many Lands." And it's one that Nancy tells me we sing quite often. I don't remember it, but the words are great. It's all about Canada. So we're going to sing three verses of it and sing really loudly. Thank you.
pray together. Loving God, as we prepare to celebrate another anniversary of Confederation, we thank you for the gift of our country, Canada. We give thanks for this magnificent country, blessed with wonderful resources and great beauty. We're thankful for a country that welcomes refugees and immigrants alike. Together with our founding citizens, Indigenous, French, and British, may we share our natural beauty and rich heritage with all who call this country home. May we continue to strive for national unity and for peace. We pray that we will be true and faithful stewards of our land, that we'll be ever mindful of our carbon footprint and strive to preserve and protect our resources. We're thankful for the freedom of religion and conscience, for a system of government that provides us the right to speak freely, laws that are based on equality, respect for cultural differences, and a commitment to social justice. We give thanks. And may we commit to working harder to make these freedoms real in every person's life and experience. Bless our leaders. Grant wisdom to those who govern. Help us as Christians, inspired by your Spirit, to use our voices to guide them as they make difficult and monumentous decisions. Leading a country during a time such as this is no easy feat. So following the prayer of David's Psalms, we ask that you give our Prime Minister your justice, O God. May he judge your people with righteousness and your poor with justice. May he defend the cause of the poor and give deliverance to the needy. May he be like rain that falls on mown grass, like showers that water the earth. And in this time, may righteousness flourish and peace abound. For all these gifts, most especially the gift of your love showered daily upon us, we give you thanks. And may you have dominion from sea to sea, in our community, in our church, in our lives, and to the ends of the earth. For we pray in Christ's name. Amen. Happy Canada Day as you celebrate this week. I hope that you have an opportunity to be patriotic and to share that patriotism and love of country with somebody else. Just wave a flag, wear red and white, do something to mark this special day. And remember that we are blessed people. So bless somebody else. Have a great week, everyone.
Hi, Thamesview. So I have a few extra little gadgets today. I've hooked myself up to my computer here. And what this COVID thing has done is it's allowed me some chances to explore technology. And I have this nice little unit here that affects my keyboard. So I have these nice little sounds like. Isn't that pretty? And so I'm gonna use that for this piece that the choir has sung several times. It's called Thankful. And it's the song Thankful. It's also a hymn called Thanks Be to God, and they're just put together. Thankful was a song made popular by Josh Groban, and I really like it because it talks about that we have so much, and we complain, and we aren't satisfied, and there's so much that we can be thankful for, and there's a line in it, it's up to us to be the change, and I think that's important. I think if we sit back and don't do anything ourselves, we're not helping the situation. We're actually exacerbating the problem. So sit back and enjoy this piece. I'm going to put the lyrics up and absorb it. Got to get my piano sound here.